Inspectors late. Commentary of Vision Press production. On June 1, 2023 at 7 p.m., the Irvona Borough Council convened a regular scheduled monthly meeting of council for the business of the borough. During the meeting, Borough Secretary Amber Deal announced that on June 29, 2023 at 8 a.m., inspectors would be on site to review the Borough of Irvona Flood Protection Fortress created for the benefit of residents of Irvona. The inspectors were construed to be DEP waterway engineers personnel who would be on site. Vision Press production was at the Irvona Borough Building at 7:30 a.m. to ensure attendance at the scheduled meeting. At 8:30 a.m. with no appearance of inspectors or borough personnel, Vision Press Production, VPP, personnel went to the flood protection site to see if the inspectors were at the site. They were not. VPP reporter returned to the Irvona Borough Office at 9:30 a.m. Borough Secretary Deal explained two inspectors met at the building and one connected with the other inspector driving together to the site. According to the two federal inspectors, between 8:30 and 9:30 a.m., the inspectors arrived late and found the Irvona Borough office door locked, so, the inspectors went to the flood protection site to begin procedures for review of the site. At 9:30 a.m., June 29, 2023, the VPP reporter received granted right to know law, RTKL, records supplied by Secretary Deal, who is the agency's open records officer, AORO, for Irvona Borough. Graciously, AORO Deal presented all the documents with explanations of each document with her kindness. After formal thank you to AORO Deal, VPP reporter went to the site to identify the inspectors. Discovery was made. The inspectors were two U.S. federal employees alleged to be U.S. Army Corps of Engineer personnel. VPP reporter asked for business cards. The gentleman who did not identify himself, stated, "I do not have a business card." VPP report asked a question. The gentleman responded, "That is above my pay grade." The borough worker accompanying the two inspectors, "The inspectors are from the Army Corps of Engineer. This year it is the Corps, next year, DEP, the Department of Environmental Protection, will be on site for a yearly review. The two entities alternate each year and do not come at the same time." A verbose request was asked of the gentleman inspector. "If a report is produced, will you send me a copy?" said the VPP reporter. No response of affirmation was granted. VPP reporter departed to secure proper attire to walk in the 2-foot weeds on the flood project site near the former TYK property. Returning to the flood project site at 10 a.m., videoing at a distance, the gentleman and gentlelady inspectors were observed on the levee near the Whitmer Run discharge area, juxtaposition with the former TYK property. The VPP reporter went to the inspectors seeking a video interview. VPP reporter was denied an interview. The gentle lady suggested to the gentleman inspector as a question, "Shouldn't he, VPP reporter, consult public relations?" The VPP reporter off camera was requesting, "What are the variables of inspection?" VPP reporter was denied any answers. So, VPP reporter departed the site due to refusal of answers by inspectors remaining silent. VPP reporter did ask if there was a review session at the borough office. No answer was granted. VPP reporter did receive an email from the borough secretary Deal that the inspectors did meet at the borough office for summation. VPP was denied knowledge of this conclusion meeting at the borough officer after all the flood protection site was totally reviewed. According to the email timestamp, the summation conclusion meeting was at 11:25 a.m. Vision Press Production Committee believed it would have been an important discovery meeting if the U.S. Army Corps of Engineer Inspectors would have given some guidance into their process, so that the public could understand the importance of inspections. Vision Press production personnel, the reporter on site, worked with the DEP Department Waterways engineers for 8 years. Each year, DEP paid for accommodations, room, and board, for the Reverend Gerald W. Spade, Sr. to travel to DEP seminars to study flood protection project resources for a week each year. The information was worth thousands of dollars of engineering skills and remedies for flood protection. Networking with the DEP personnel developed friendships and resource personnel for future work and development. With this in mind, Coalport Borough had a Borough of Coalport Flood Protection Project, DGS 182-14, entitled and defined as Clearfield Creek and Blaine Run Flood Protection. This project DGS 182-14 included the replacement of the bridge over Blaine Run located on West Railroad Street, in Coalport Borough, Clearfield County, Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. The bridge was covered under the grant. The project was suspended by the Coalport Borough Council in 2018. The borough will need to return $196,000 expended in the sponsorship agreement due to breach of contract. Why has Coalport not been contacted for the return of monies granted for the sponsorship agreement? Irvona Borough signed a sponsorship agreement, according to RTKL grant of documents supplied by the AORO deal. The borough has a Pledget bank account entitled Irvona Borough Flood Protection Fund, 42, in the amount $5,216.32 required in the sponsorship agreement for the Irvona Borough Flood Protection Responsibility. Vision Press Production, believing you have the right to know under the Constitution of the United States, was set aside and threatened by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineer Inspectors, according to the email from Irvona Borough. In regard to the Irvona Borough Flood Protection Real Site, there are islands in the middle of the Clearfield Creek. When VPP reporter asked about the islands, the gentleman inspector had no knowledge of a remedy. According to DEP training, Reverend Spade was taught that lateral barriers in the stream would create hydraulics, and has been proven that the barriers extending out into the creek would wash the islands away. Graphic pictorial exhibits presented by DEP demonstrated the hydraulic pressure of the barriers at the site near the island would eliminate the island. Think of your thumb as one of the barriers, over a hose when water is expelled from the hose. With your thumb on the hose, great pressure is produced to wash debris off your driveway or sidewalk. The gentleman stated that is above my pay grade. The gentleman had no opinion. What is the role of an inspector? Why were the inspectors present? Will the inspectors, and or, will the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers respectfully serve a copy of the inspector's site review for June 29, 2023 developed for the Irvona Borough Flood Protection Site to Vision Press Production? Vision Press Production believes in the right to know, and upholds the Constitution of the United States of America and the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. VPP is working to purport the truth and present the facts. Respectfully, Vision Press Production.